Hey, how's it going? It's Sophia here from Zen Guidance. I hope you're doing well, and thank you so much for clicking on today's Pick a Card reading. So in this reading, we're going to be looking at your person's feelings versus your feelings. So if you want to get into how your person is feeling about you in comparison to how you feel, this is the reading for you. So all you need to do is choose one of the three roses on your screen. Once you've made your choice, you can go to the description box below, where you'll find the corresponding timestamps to your chosen pile. You'll also find the link to my website, so if you'd like to book a personal reading with me, that's where you need to go. Okay, so let's get into your reading. Click the timestamp and I'll see you there. Hi group one. So let's take a look at your person's feelings versus your feelings. I'm not gonna take that because I'm actually going to split the reading up into two different parts on different sides. So over here on the left will be your feelings and over here on the right will be your person's. Okay, so let's get into your feelings first because this will also help you to know that this is definitely the pile for you because obviously you know how you feel. So if this aligns, then you'll have reassurance that it's aligning with how your person feels or in terms of what comes through the reading. Okay, so how are you currently feeling about your person? How are you currently feeling about your person? Dignified strength. The fifth house, passion. Oh, Pallas Athena. Think. Okay, we've had no zodiac. Oh no, I guess we have. We've had a Leo come through. That's the sign. One sign that's come through, which you may resonate. Of course, I'll keep going. More signs will come up. But you may also have certain planets that are in their exaltation or their dignification, like Mars in Aries or Venus in Taurus or Libra, for example. Okay, or the Sun in Leo. Now, how you feel about your person? Yeah, I do feel that there is still a lot of passion here, okay, that you have for them. I feel like you're highly attracted to them. And there's also this sense I feel like you want to nurture this connection. And I feel like this is you thinking about it a lot, okay? You may be struggling to get this person off your mind lately. Even if you feel like for whatever reason it's not right or you're trying to move on, it feels like there's still something pulling you in. Yeah, I just feel like the attraction is so powerful between the two of you, or certainly looking at your side first. Okay, I feel like you want to have fun with this person. Maybe you're not seeing them as somebody you could have a long-term relationship with. Okay, that may be something that you feel isn't possible. For some of you, that may be the case, or you may just be thinking, yeah, I would just like to have fun. Or I would at least like to start with fun because this is about dating as well. And I feel like, yeah, it's something about you wanting to spend some quality time with them, having fun, not being too heavy about things. But I also get this sense from you that you may be putting on a bit of a front with this person. Did you see that? The way they just flew out. They both flew out sideways, which is interesting. But I'll get to those in a second. I want to continue what I was saying here. Now, yeah, something about you feeling like you need to be in a strong place, like you don't want to appear needy or appear like you're still that into them, but it's like you don't also want to push them away at the same time. Another one jumped out, so let's see what that is. Material harvest. Okay, I'm just going to take them as they are here. Yeah, I feel like there is this sense of restlessness here, okay? Like you're wanting something more from this. Like you don't feel satisfied, you feel like you're not getting enough. And I feel like this might be what's causing you to like overthink this a lot because you're feeling a sense of lack when it comes to this person. And it's like a craving almost, like a sense you're like craving this person, like craving sugar or something. It's like, it's really intense, I feel, these cravings. And I feel like it's causing you to maybe even feel like you need to keep yourself busy with other things, like you're trying to distract yourself from this. Maybe you're also trying to distract yourself from reaching out, okay? Because again, it's like you're trying to remain in a controlled place, but then there's a part of you that just wants to like leap in, like jump into their arms if you see them, or send them a message, or engage with them through social media or something. Like there's something here where it's like you feel this impulsivity to connect with them, but it's like you're worried about taking a risk, okay? Like you're worried that you're not necessarily going to receive this material harvest if you do this, okay? I feel like this may be what you're afraid of. But there's also this part where I feel like you're very independent. Okay, 1 second, I'm just having a sip of my coffee. Like there's a sense of being very free, and I feel like there is this part of you that does want freedom in this connection. Like you may yourself not be looking for more. Like you may actually want to just see where it goes, taking it day by day rather than like this has to be something serious. You may even be enjoying being single or being free of this connection in some way. Yeah. Now this may also be a side note that you're doing really well financially, or you may start to do really well financially, which will help when it comes to your feelings. Okay, so I'm just going to get a couple more on this. I don't want to spend too much time on your feelings because I know the main reason you're here is to look at how your person feels, but just to get an idea as to how you really feel. Okay, so we have conclusions are within reach. Luck is on your side. We've got Sagittarius now coming through. We do also have the sign of Aries here, Virgo, Libra. A win-win outcome is forecast. Yes, it's like, I feel like there's unfinished business here of some kind. Like you may even be feeling, yeah, there's unfinished business. It's not gotten to the place that I want it to get to. Or I feel like even though you're very happy, or you seem to be happy, or maybe this is the front that you're putting on, that you're happy being single or happy being very independent, liberated from the connection. But I feel like you just crave to have that balance with them. Like you just want to feel like you're both on the same page, that you're both willing to put in the time and the effort. And it's like you'd be willing to put in the time with them if you knew that they wanted that or they were willing to reciprocate. It's interesting because we've got luck is on your side and a win-win outcome is forecast. So yeah, something that feels very lucky about this connection. Okay, or how you feel right now. So maybe you feel like things have taken a turn for the better recently. Like you may be in more communication with your person, or maybe you know of an event or something that you're attending where you know you're going to see them. Or maybe this is more of a sense of optimism and you feeling that I'm just going to remain positive. This is what I would like to happen. I'm not going to over-focus on the end result and just go with the flow here. Okay, but yeah, again, I feel like you potentially do want more from this person, but it has to feel like it's equal. It has to feel like it's reciprocal. Otherwise, you're not going to take any more potential risks, okay? So now let's take a look into your person, okay? What are their feelings, current feelings for you? Okay, oh, my hair was caught on the mic then. Right. So, your person, group number one, person on your mind, what are their current thoughts and feelings about you? What are their current thoughts and feelings about you? Okay, we have Midheaven, Pinnacle, Taurus, Cultivate, and Aries, Act. Wow, okay. So there is passion on both sides. Okay, so that's something immediately that I see, that there is reciprocal passion attraction. So if that's something you were wondering, wonder no more, group one, because your person, they have this urge to come towards you in the same way that you have this urge to come towards them. Like you're both feeling the same way. Although I feel like this person may be a little bit more stubborn than you. yeah, with this Taurus, which is fixed earth. So I feel that they sometimes, like, their ego gets in the way, okay? Or they need to be right. Like, if they don't feel like it's right, so you may feel like they need to be the one to reach out next, but in their mind, I get the sense that they may feel like you need to be the one. Although they still want to connect with you, but they're, like I said, there's a bit of a stubbornness getting in the way here. But I also feel like they're highly focused on their career, or they're climbing some sort of ladder. They've got a goal that they're trying to reach. Now, maybe a career goal, it may be a fitness goal, doesn't matter what it is. It's something here which I feel is outside of your connection that may be in some way interfering. Okay, this may be causing them to have to put your connection on the back burner. Or this may be an excuse they even use. Oh, this is why I can't reach out to you, because, oh, I've got to focus on work, or I'm traveling, or I've got no signal, or, you know, they're just coming up with excuses after excuses here as to why they can't reach out or why they can't take action. But there's definitely something about action here that they're either wanting or they may end up doing, but we will see. Okay, what are your person's current feelings towards you? The person on your mind, what are their current feelings towards you? Wow, what did I say? Passion ignited. Oh, and another one flew. Financial and material changes. And intuition. So they've got a block in their intuition right now. They may not be seeing things very clearly, or they may even be misreading signs. Like, they may be seeing signs about you and about your connection, but they're either ignoring them or they're misinterpreting them in some way. Yeah, because it doesn't feel like they're following it, even though it's like their intuition, I feel like, is guiding them to reach out to you. But they're ignoring this urge currently. Now, we do have the financial and material changes, so that does make sense. If they've recently lost a job, or maybe they've got a large bill or debt that needs to be paid that's just come up, or they're having to move homes, or something that's costing them a lot of money right now. I definitely feel like money is weighing heavily on their mind. And I get this sense as well that this is leading them to feel somewhat insecure. They may not even feel like they're good enough for you right now, or they may not feel like they've got enough to offer you. But the passion is there. The passion is there. Look how brightly it shines. Ace of Wands. They really do want something more to happen with you. And I feel like they certainly want something intimate to happen. And I feel like you want that too. You're both wanting this. Now, I'm trying to keep it PG for you two, but I'm picking up a lot of this very intimate, private energy. Like, you both feel like you want to spend one-on-one time together. Definitely this need to just be at one with each other, that keeps coming through. But like alone, somewhere private, like a bedroom, okay? It's very, very intense. Believe in the impossible. Blue moon. The energy is gaining momentum. Be bold and make the first move. Okay, so definitely your person is thinking about reaching out, and I feel like they're going to end up doing it. Okay, now this may not be for everybody, I appreciate. It may be that they allow themselves to be stopped here by what's going on financially, but there's so much fire coming through. Like, and this is like building. The energy is gaining momentum. That is the waxing moon phase of the moon gaining light. We're actually in that phase right now as I'm recording this. So there is this building of light, building of understanding and truth. I feel like your person is definitely working up the courage to reach out. There's definitely something that is scaring them off a little bit, but they certainly feel like they need to make the first move. But they feel in some way it would be very bold of them to do it. Maybe you ignored them, maybe you blocked them, or maybe things didn't go well the last time you spoke, or they're just really afraid that you may reject them. And I feel like that's the biggest reason as to why they have been holding back. But like I said, for the majority of you, I feel like they're going to push through this because there's too much fire. And I feel like it's kind of driving them crazy because they want to have clarity and they will get to this point where they accept the fact that you may reject them. And they'd rather even that happen than continue in this ambiguity or uncertainty any longer. Because that's what, we don't like this, do we? We don't like uncertainty as human beings. Hence why these readings are helpful or exist. I hope it's helpful. Please give the video a like if it is. But yeah, they feel like it's an impossible feat. Like this person, I feel like they see you as being out of their league in some way. You are also like this pinnacle for them. Like they have to reach. Like you're not somebody that's on their usual level. And it's not about anybody being better than anybody else, but this is from their perspective. They feel like you've got a lot more going for you than they currently do. Now, you may not see them in that way, and that may not be the truth of how everybody else sees them, but in how they feel about themselves, they're a very, very harsh critic internally. They want to succeed, and I feel like they want to connect with you. They want to feel like they can succeed in that, but there's this worry that it is impossible, but I feel like they are starting to believe it is possible. So maybe you've given them a signal recently, some kind of sign that lets them know that you would be interested or that you would reciprocate. Again, if you haven't done this, this may be something either that you do moving forwards, very recent, in the very near future, or like I said, it may be signs that they're receiving. I just feel like they keep seeing your name, like your first name. Whenever they're online, social media, or they're at work, like your name just keeps flashing in front of their eyes. And I feel like that's something that really, again, drives them a bit crazy. So they just feel like, okay, what is the reason I keep seeing this? I'm not used to seeing this. I'm going to have to find out. Now, the thing is, what I'm not seeing on either side here is a lot of emotion, especially as we're looking at your feelings. So I do feel like both of you are actually keeping your emotional feelings at bay. It's not to say that neither of you have emotion for each other, but I do feel that, yeah, you're both trying to remain as logical as you can about this and not get too swept away in the emotion of it. But there is passion, there is drive. You both want to connect. But yeah, I feel like you are going to wait. Because again, you don't feel like it's the right time or the place for you to make any moves. And you're waiting for this person. And you're in the right space because they do want to connect. And I do feel, like I said, for most of you, they are going to reach out and connect. So let's just get some more cards here. Okay. I'm just going to stick with your person now. Your person's current feelings for you. There it is. Take risk. Take a risk. That's it. They want to take a risk when it comes to you. Okay? They don't want this to be over. Okay? They know that it's going to be risky. They know that you may reject them. Even this card just flew out, the Five of Cups. That's the first emotional card that has come through, especially as I was just mentioning that. So your person is definitely afraid of being hurt, but I almost feel like, yeah, they're getting to this point where they can't, they feel like they're going to hurt themselves either way. Like if they lose you, they could feel a lot worse than if they hold back and never try. Okay, so we've got the Ten of Wands. Eight of Wands. This person is so up and down. So up and down. Whoa. Okay, it's quite extreme, actually. Extreme ups and downs. Okay. I really feel they're going to reach out. Okay, we've got the Ace of Swords here. they've received some sort of clarity. Okay, I actually feel like they may have been going through a breakup before you came together, like quite recently. There may have been a little bit of on and off between this person and them. But there's this sense of them giving up, okay? I feel like they're no longer willing to hold on to past connections or even hold on to the pain of your connection. And it feels like this is them wanting to rush in. They want to rush in towards you very quickly. And they want to speak to you. They want to gain some sort of clarity. They may even want to be honest with you about something. It doesn't feel like it's emotional though. This doesn't feel like it's like an apology or something sweet. I feel like this will be more logical. Like they'll really think it out before they send it. Because as well, they're not in the best place. I mean, the Ten of Swords is pretty bad. Very heavy mental energy. And I feel like, yeah, they don't want to feel like this anymore. They realize that the only way for them to pull themselves out of this is to reach out to you, one way or the other. But yes, there is a level of strategy here with your person. They're definitely thinking about how to come towards you or what to say. Okay, it's like they almost want a foolproof message, something that really feels like it's not going to fail. So it might be something kind of innocuous, something about your work or their work or a mutual friend or something that's very low maintenance in hopes that you'll respond. So we're just going to get some fishbowl messages on this as well, your person's feelings for you. Text message arise. We've got ghost and then text message arise. False promises. Okay. Push to the limit. Travel consultant. Politician. Okay. So yeah, we have that confirmation. I do feel they're going to reach out to you by text or DM. Okay. Now, you may be worried that they're going to give you a false promise. Okay, I sense that this might be something you're worried about with this person. I don't feel like it's them thinking you're going to false promise them. It feels like maybe this is even something that happened previously. Now, the ghost here, obviously somebody is ghosted. Okay, I feel like it was you that ghosted them, but of course, do reverse the energy if it makes more sense, if they ghosted you. Either way, they're definitely thinking about it. They're thinking about the implications of this, whether you did it to them or they did it to you. It's definitely on their mind. This may even be what they say when they reach out. But like I said, I don't really feel like it's an apology, but maybe it doesn't feel like an apology, or maybe like, sorry, I was really busy. So it doesn't come across as like overly sweet, but it seems quite straight to the point and maybe even a little bit blunt. But yeah, look, your person right now is pushed to the limit. You know, they can't go any further in their life, okay, until they rectify situations, okay? Situations with you, but also in their personal life, in their career, in their financial situation. They're pushed to the limit in all these different ways. And I feel like they're trying to regain control. Excuse me. With politician, I don't know. This is something maybe that's up for debate. Maybe you've got the same political views. Maybe these are conversations that you've had previously. Could be something they even do for work. Okay, they work within politics. Something like that could be. Could also be that they work in travel, but they may also be traveling a lot. May even be something political is affecting their travel plans. Okay, I know that doesn't feel like it's got anything to do with you. But I mean, it's come through in your reading. So maybe this is what has been stopping them, okay, from reaching out. Or maybe this is what triggers them to reach out. Say, like, they go away somewhere or their flight gets cancelled and they're having to wait around. They may decide to reach out to you then, okay? Or they may just, yeah, something about traveling and reaching out. So either if something is cancelled, they're going to reach out, triggered by this. Or if they're away, you know what it's like. You feel more nostalgic when you go to a different country and you can think about people back in your country and feel like a sense of longing and a sense of missing, like more so than if you're just in the same country. Well, I don't know, I feel like that anyway. I don't know if you guys ever feel like that, but like for me, I mean, I guess it's just homesickness. I don't necessarily feel homesick, maybe a little bit, but like I said, I'll feel like I'll miss people, but of course we all miss people, but it just feels more when you're like separated by countries or water or borders. But yeah, let me know if you feel the same. Now, I'm going to finish off with some message cards, okay? So, your person's current feelings towards you. In between trying to heal from you, but still holding on to hope for us to be once more. So yeah, they haven't given up on this, if that's something you're wondering. They definitely haven't given up. But they've definitely been in two minds about this. Whether they should heal and let go, or whether they should hold on. But they are still holding on to hope, even though they feel like it may be impossible right now. It drives me insane to have no closure from you. And I'm not surprised to see that one, because what did I say? They've been driven crazy by this. They don't know how you feel. Even though you may feel like you've been transparent with them, but I don't know, maybe you haven't been. Like, you may have given them a few mixed messages yourself, okay? Because again, they see this as unfinished business and they don't like it, okay? It definitely drives them crazy and it causes them to obsess over this and obsess over you, group number one. I can't access my heart right now. And that does make sense with everything that's come through. Like, they're not coming from a heartfelt place. Now, it's not to say that they don't care about you, or that you don't care about each other, just because a lot of emotion hasn't come up. But for them, it feels like right now they can't go there on that emotional level. Now, they may be able to open up their heart if you two can come together and make it work over time. But right now, whilst things are so up in the air, they're not allowing themselves to go that deep, okay? But again, it's all up in their head. There's passion and there's obsession, but there is emotional unavailability right now. But this, I feel like, is what's actually keeping them grounded, because they've been being driven so crazily by all of this that if their heart was too engaged right now, that I feel like it would just send them to a really bad place, because they're already quite fragile. So for them, it's like they are protecting themselves right now. But yes, I would expect a message to come through very soon. Now, I'm just going to get a time frame for you on this. Just remember, with timing, it's always fluid and changeable. So please take it with a pinch of salt. It's usually after the fact that it makes sense, but just put it to the back of your mind. Okay, now you couldn't see this, but it is the number 6, okay? So this could be 6 days. Now, we do have Taurus and Saturn. Now, this could be during Taurus season. It's definitely not going to be when Saturn is in Taurus, because that's going to be years from now, because Saturn is so slow moving and it's only in the sign of Pisces right now. It may be when, no, the Sun won't conjunct Saturn now. It's already done that. Now, so, okay, it may be Taurus season, especially if you're watching this now. Taurus season is really close. It's only a few days away. So that would make sense. 6 days would make sense. I feel at the most it'll be 6 weeks, 6 months. Okay, obviously it'll be different for everybody, but it could even be the 6th of the month. Okay, the 6th of next month, or if 6 is coming up in this month, it could be on that particular day. So there it is. That is what I see for you. If you'd like to book a personal reading with me, the link to my website is below, where we can go a lot more into detail and obviously look at this personally for you. And of course, it is tailor-made for you specifically. So if this interests you, just click the link down below in the description box, which will take you to my website. And please let me know in the comments if this resonated. Even just putting an emoji is helpful. Like, for instance, put a bird emoji if this resonates with you. I'll do different emojis for each pile, but especially if you don't want to give much away, you don't want to be too open, But just, yeah, any engagement I really do appreciate. And subscribe if you haven't already. Okay, so I hope this made sense and I hope you have a lovely rest of your day. Bye for now. Hey, group two. So let's take a look at your person's feelings, the person on your mind, as well as your feelings. I'm going to begin with your feelings first, because this will help you to know that this is the correct pile for you, because of course you know how you feel at this moment in time. So if this resonates, hopefully it'll corroborate the fact that how your person feels will make sense, okay? If it doesn't resonate, then of course, please choose another pile. Okay, so let's take a look at your current feelings. What are your current feelings for your person, the person on your mind? Okay, we've got Cancer. Scorpio, ooh. Okay, Pluto, ooh, what is going on here, group two? So there is a lot of emotion coming through here. A lot of emotion. We've got three emotional signs and planets. Pluto rules Scorpio. So we've got double Scorpio here. So you may resonate with Scorpio energy, your person may do, or Cancer, of course. Now, there's something secretive, I feel, about this connection. Now, this may be you keeping secret how you feel about this person. You may be hiding the fact that you have a crush or that you're interested in them or that you still care, okay? You may be putting on a front when it comes to this. But this may also be that there is a secret element to the connection. Like it could be like a third party situation, for instance, if you know that's the case, whether it's on your side or theirs, okay? It could be you're having to keep it secret from other people or from if you work together. Or if you've got mutual friends, there's something here where it feels like it needs to be hidden from other people. Maybe even social media, okay? Something about this I feel like you're wanting to keep private. But I do feel that there's some obsessive energy coming through here too. So you may be feeling quite obsessed with this person. You may be struggling to not think about them, not let them go. You may be stalking them even. Whether it's in person or social media, or trying to facilitate ways of seeing them, or trying to get their attention, or I just feel like your attention is hyper-focused on this person right now. It's like you've got this tunnel vision, and it's like, I want you, and that's final. So yeah, it's very intense. One second, I just need to cough. Sorry about that. Now, I also feel like even though there's this intensity, there's also a sweetness here. Okay, the Cancer, it's like, it's very nurturing, motherly, wants to look after them. So I don't know, it's like, there's a part of you that wants to look after this person. Maybe even like you want to save them in some way. There's definitely this feeling of, yeah, I just want to, like, if you just want to be in their arms, I just want to hug them, or I just want to cook for them, or I just want to make them feel happy, to do things for them, to be of service in some way. But this may also be that you're wanting them to do that for you, to reciprocate if you don't feel like you're getting that, okay? But also something about spending time at home. Spending time privately, for sure, is coming through, but the home specifically, but also Cancer rules the bed. Okay, now it doesn't have to be a non-PG moment. Of course, it might be that, you know, you want to be very physical with them. Scorpio does rule sex. Okay, so it could have, you know, there could be a very strong passion for that. But I also get the sense that it's like you may just want to cuddle with this person or spoon them or have them spoon you. Like it feels very intimate but sweet. Being very close to each other. I feel like you're longing for that. Now, there may also be something about children here. You may have a child that you're trying to factor into this connection, or maybe they have a child that you're trying to factor in to your feelings and to what you want moving forwards. Maybe you're even seeing this person as being the potential parent to your children one day. But what's also catching my attention here is that we've got the crab and we've got the Scorpio. Okay, the scorpion. Both have like those pinches, the claws. Okay, something about pinching. I wonder what that means. I really don't know why I'm drawn to that. Maybe that will become clear later. I'll get some more information here. Now, this may also be an element of control because we've got this double Scorpio Pluto. Yeah, this may be that there you feel like you need to control something here. You feel like you don't have power or, yeah, like I said, about over-strategizing things in some way, overthinking it all. Now, this may also be that you've recently split with this person because Scorpio can represent death and endings. So it may be that there was a recent split or something's come to an end between the two of you. Okay, we just had the Triumphant Success card fly out. Okay. How are you feeling about your person? The Crown Chakra, ooh. And Harmony, the Lovers. So, yes, you definitely feel a very strong connection to your person. Yes, wow. Now, there's something about you wanting success, okay? Maybe you reached out to this person, because this is the Ace of Swords, okay? So maybe you reached out to them. Or maybe they reached out to you and you didn't know what to say, or there's been some kind of truth or clarity that's come to the surface here. But with this Crown Chakra, there's something here where you feel like it's quite spiritual, actually. So you may be having dreams about this person or seeing signs connected to them. Or you feel in some way it was divinely guided, like you were meant to come together for a greater purpose, to create change on a bigger scale in some way. It's very, very powerful. And the Lovers, yeah, I mean, you're very attracted to this person, highly attracted, but I don't feel like it's just a physical thing. I feel like there's definitely emotion involved here. And yeah, your heart chakra is activated with this person. Like you may actually feel that in your heart when you think of them, and you can actually feel that kind of pang or that feeling in your heart chakra. Like that is how this person makes you feel. Even if you may not want to, even if you don't feel like it's right, whatever the case may be, it's like you feel drawn to this person like a moth to a flame, okay? And there's no escaping it. Okay. I'm just gonna get one more set of cards here for your feelings, and then I will get into your person's. Okay. How are you currently feeling about them? Your dreams need a practical plan. Taurus energy, which you or your person could resonate with. And so what did I say as well about being strategic? I feel like this is you thinking, what is it that I need to do to get this person? What do I need to say? How do I need to act? What do I even need to post in order to get their attention? There's something here you want to put some kind of practical step into making things happen. But then there's also this part of you that feels like you need to surrender to this. So maybe you want to reach out, but I feel like you don't want to do it directly. If anything, I feel like this is more covert. So you may feel that you have to do it in a hidden way or to give them some kind of, not on purpose mixed messages, but something that lets them know that you are interested in them or even still interested in them. Okay, but there's a part of you that feels like it's not your place to reach out to them. And you're very close to achieving your goal, Gibbous Moon. Definitely something with the success, the goal. I don't know if you see this person as a goal. I just whacked the mic arm in a really like awkward position. That really hurt. Okay. But yeah, so there's something about winning here. Maybe there is a bit of ego activation on your part. You may feel like, I don't want them, but I want them to want me. Or I just want to know that they're still interested and then I can move on. So for some of you, that may be the case. Like you're willing to let them go if you just have some kind of 3D clarity from them that they were just as interested. Or maybe that you were both on the same page, that you both felt a strong connection to each other and that it wasn't one-sided. Okay, and I do feel like this is letting you know that you are going to gain that clarity soon. I don't feel like This merry-go-round of confusion is going to continue much further. So just know that you are going to be out of this, okay? This pain, this obsession, this need to control, this need to be with them. I do feel something's coming out here. Something is coming out. So what are your person's current feelings for you, group two? The person on your mind, what are their current feelings? Okay, so we have the sixth house, house of Virgo, the North Node, destiny, future, and Juno, partnership. Wow, okay. So I do feel like they are seeing you as relationship material, okay, or partnership material. Juno is the marriage asteroid in astrology, or long-term partnership. So your personal Juno will indicate the type of person you're going to marry or be with for the long term. Okay, so your person is definitely considering things to be long-term with you, or sees the potential for things to be long-term with you. I mean, look at the two parrots, beautiful macaws. I don't know what they call them. What do they call them? Something gold. I'm sure there's gold in there when they're like this blue and yellow. Beautiful birds. I feel like there's something about you being a very beautiful couple, actually. Like, you both are quite conventionally attractive. Maybe that's why you're drawn to each other. But there's also a similarity in the way that you look. So I don't know whether you have the same color hair, same color eyes, similar facial features, similar heights even. There's definitely something here where I feel like there's similarities in your appearance, or you may even mirror each other when, like, you meet up. You don't know what each other is going to be wearing, but you seem to be wearing the same colors every time. There's definitely something that aligns there in terms of mirroring in physicality. But yeah, they definitely are thinking about something long-term with you. But they may feel like they have to step out of their comfort zone in order to do this, in order to come towards you. But there's something here about destiny as well, where they feel like they're being pushed in a particular direction. So they may feel like you are their destiny, like their destiny is to be with you, or their destiny is to make things work with you. Now, with this sixth house, this is the house of service, the house of learning and teaching, the house of working, cleaning. So something about being of help or of service. So that may be their love language, group too. They may, acts of service may be the way that they show their love in the strongest way. So offering to do things for you, okay? Offering to help you with something or to teach you something. They definitely want to be that person for you, that solid rock where you're able to reach out to them if you're going through something, if you're needing help. They want to be that for you. They want to be that rock you can lean on, or the shoulder to cry on. Okay. Your person, how are they feeling about you? How are they currently feeling? Discontent and boredom in reverse. Fertility. So we've got more Taurus energy coming through here. There's too many. I'm only taking three of these cards. Okay. Oh my God, but there it is, of course. If you saw that, it was the heart chakra and another card that came out. But there it is. It was meant to come through. So, wow. Your person has emotion for you. So you actually both have emotion for each other. There's reciprocal feelings going on here on an emotional level. They feel it too in their heart chakra. And I can feel like emotion coming up within me. I'm trying my best not to cry, but it feels very intense. But this person definitely has, yeah, they have strong feelings in their heart for you. And again, I feel like this is something that they are questioning. Because even look here, in the green, she's got this green orb in her heart area. So they actually feel this in their heart. They feel the same pang that you feel for them. And I had a feeling that they would, based on this lover's card, because there's so much green, especially around him. So I was sensing it, but I didn't want to speak too soon. So I definitely feel like that's a confirmation here that your person, they either love you, okay, or they may have very strong feelings of like or potential love. Of course, it's different for everybody. It depends how long you've known each other, been together. Obviously, if you've just met each other like yesterday, then it's unlikely it's really going to be love. But then I guess, who knows? Love can be love at first sight. So it may be, even if it's been quick, it may be that it was a quick connection, but I get the sense that there's been some kind of loss here, and that I don't feel like their heart chakra was activated straight away with you. I feel like it's taken some time, because they're now feeling like they've missed the boat with you. So they feel like they've missed the opportunity. There was a chance for them to have growth with you, to have something stable, but it seems to have died a death. Now, this may be their fault. They may have cut this off prematurely. You may have done the same thing. Okay, but either way, they're feeling the sense of loss about this. Okay, so they feel like they may not have another opportunity to get close to you again, but they haven't let you go in their hearts. That's very clear to see. Okay, so what else is coming through about your person's feelings? Your person's feelings. The answers you need are coming. Full moon in Gemini. Wow. Okay. Luck is on your side. New moon in Sagittarius. And don't let pride get in your way. Full moon in Leo. So Leo, Sagittarius, Gemini. Now, both these signs can be connected to travel. So I don't know if your person is on the move at this moment in time. They might be traveling for work or for pleasure, but they may be thinking about you even more, okay, whilst they're being on the move. But your person definitely wants to speak with you. Gemini is ruled by Mercury, the planet of communication. So they definitely want communication here, but I do feel that it's pride that is stopping them from reaching out. Now, it's not to say that they won't reach out in the future or moving forwards, but this is their feelings. And it feels like there's a part of them that feels like they would have to push their pride aside in order to reach out to you. So yeah, if you rejected them in some way, even if, for instance, they were the one to reject you first, but you retaliated with another form of rejection, like they've taken that very personally. Yeah, and I feel like there's something here. If they don't feel like they're going to get a positive response from you, they're going to keep a distance. Okay, but I do feel like they have an urge and a desire to speak with you, to clear the air or to restart things between the two of you. Okay, so I'm going to get some tarot messages, but I'm going to stick to your person's side now, because I know that that's what you want to know the most about, because you know how you feel. This was just to gain some clarity that you're picking the right pile ultimately. Okay, but your person's current feelings, the person on your mind, what are their feelings? Wow, King of Cups. They have so much, the Tower, emotion for you and passion. Okay, Four of Cups again. So yeah, they love you, okay? Or they're falling in love with you, that's for sure, okay? And this isn't like it's a page where it's brand new or it's very immature or it's very small in nature. This is a king, it's not even a knight, it's the King of Cups. So this is a mature kind of love. So maybe this is somebody you've known for a while and it's matured over time. Or maybe this person just is quite emotionally mature as a whole, or they feel that sense of maturity with their feelings. Because yeah, I do feel, like I said, there's a sense of growth here. I don't feel like, maybe it was for you, but I'm not sure it was love at first sight for your person. It feels more like it's been a grower. Like I feel like they were instantly attracted to you, instantly liked you, but it feels like there was some kind of space that then made their feelings grow for you. Okay, because there's something shocking here. So I don't know if there was an end to your connection that appeared shocking, seemed to come out of nowhere. But there's a lot of tension here, a lot of sexual tension for sure. Your person wants to connect with you on that level as well as an emotional level. And they're holding on here. They are not giving up, even though they, it's crazy though, because it's like if they're not going to do anything about it, but they're not actually willing to let you go in their heart. They're keeping you there. They're hoping for a second chance. They are. They're holding on here, but yeah. There's a part of them that is being too rigid, too stubborn to put their pride aside and actually reach out and make this right with you. It's almost like you may have even given them a little signal. You've given them something and they're still refusing. They're still refusing to actually acknowledge this. They're refusing to give you anything right now. So yeah, they're being, in this way, they're being a bit like a stubborn child because they're ignoring what they really want and what they feel actually would be the right thing to do. But this may be a confidence issue. So your person's feelings, what else is coming through, please? The Outlaw, okay. So there's something rebellious about that energy. Now, this may be that they see you as a bit of an outlaw. If you're someone that's quite rebellious or you do things your own way, or it kind of feels like they see you as doing things very differently to other people they've dated previously. You handle yourself differently. You handle them differently. It's something that they're not used to, but I feel like they like it. Okay, I feel like this is something that actually draws them to you, is this unconventional energy about you. Like, you do things your own way and you're not just going to succumb to whatever it is that they want you to do or how they want you to act. It's like you are your own individual person and you stand very strong in that. But yeah, there's also something about this unpredictability. So yeah, they may see you as being a bit unpredictable, which also draws them closer to you. Okay, so we're gonna get some fishbowl messages on this as well. Your person's current feelings towards you. Okay, I'll read them out in just a sec. I'm just going to pull them out first. Okay. So we've got confidence. I feel like this is a mixture of them feeling confident about you, even though, yeah, there are times they don't feel the most confident, but they're confident in how they feel. I don't feel like they're questioning it. I don't see them flip-flopping and wondering, do I feel this way, do I not? I feel like they're very confident in knowing that they care about you very deeply. You know, we've got the 12th house, we've got Pisces, we've got Aries as the first house. Explore, psychic, soulmate, breakthrough, wow. Okay, so they may see you as being quite psychic. Maybe you are someone intuitive, maybe you work within the psychic industry. Or maybe they do, okay? But there's something here. They know that they want to come together with you, but they feel like now is not the right time. There is definitely something holding them back here. Yeah. I feel like they're waiting for a breakthrough here. They are waiting for an opportunity to make things work with you again. So if this is somebody that you see regularly, they may just be waiting for you to bump into each other and then they can get things going again. Obviously, if this is somebody that's online or if there's long distance between the two of you, they may be looking for some kind of opening online or through social media or something where they feel like they can get your attention again or you can they can get things back on track with you. But they see you as their soulmate, their lover, the person that they want to spend their life with. But then there's this confusion here between this house of suffering here, the Pisces energy, between and then wanting to take action and moving forwards. Now, this will be very specific, but for some of you, they may actually be in hospital or they may be visiting somebody in hospital. Or some kind of institution or prison. 12th house can represent all of those places. So it could be that that's something that's actually holding them back. So they're waiting until their health gets better or until someone else's health gets better, perhaps. Because the first house is about thyself. It is the physical body. It is about appearance. Appearance is the first impression you make. I mean, I definitely know they're attracted to you physically. Okay, they're very attracted to you physically. Like I said, I feel like you're both quite conventionally attractive and they see that. But there's something here. I do feel like they want to come towards you, but there's a part of them that feels like they need to hold off for the minute. Now, this may be that they previously were exploring other options. For some of you, I feel like that might be the case, but they're done because they're so focused on you now, for sure. But this may also be if they are exploring in terms of travel, in terms of their work, in terms of other areas they're exploring, or even exploring ways to make this happen with you again. Okay, so I'm just gonna get some message cards. You felt perfect, but I know perfect never lasts. So yeah, they definitely hold you in high regard here. But yeah, there's a part of them that worries that it's all going to come crashing down. You feel safe to me. I know you will never judge me. That's such soulmate energy. Like there's a sense of them feeling comfortable with you. Even though there's this, I feel like there's a little bit of intimidation as well, but yeah, something about you being very non-judgmental, okay? Or maybe that you know them so well that they know that genuinely that you're not going to judge them. And in between trying to heal from you, but still holding on to hope for us to be once more. So there's the confusion. There's the bit of the flip-flopping, okay, in terms of the action. They know that they still care about you. They know that they love you. That's very clear to them. But maybe this is about compatibility, because you can love someone, you can like someone, you can like them in so many different ways. You can care about them deeply, but it doesn't mean you are compatible in terms of your lifestyles, in terms of your goals, your moral values, your character, family, friends, all of those things that are going to affect a relationship long term. So this may be what's been holding you both back, the level of long-term compatibility. But they haven't been able to let you go, even though that I feel like at times they've been trying to heal from you. But they still hold out hope. So yeah, they're not willing to give up on this just yet. So this is what I see. I really hope it does resonate. Please do comment below. Like comment a flower emoji if it did resonate, especially if you don't want to write anything too in detail, but it just lets me know that it made sense and that I'm on the right track for you. Because I do like to know that these readings resonate with you. So yeah, please do share your comments or just give the video a like. That lets me know that, again, I'm on the right path. And feel free to give the video a dislike if it didn't resonate. All engagement is welcome here. Unless it is super negative comments, I do not welcome that, because sometimes it's just unnecessary. And I don't like how negativity breeds negativity. So sometimes I will delete comments as well if I find it to be a very negative one, and if it's spiraling, I don't need that negativity on the channel. But everybody is always entitled to their opinion. Just have respect. That's all I ask for. Some people don't treat me like I'm a real human being, creating these videos free out of my own time for you guys. So please do respect that, but do feel free to be open. Just be kind always, okay? And if you'd like to book a personal reading with me, the link to my website is below. I do hope you have a lovely rest of your day. Bye for now. Hi, Group 3. So let's take a look at your person's feelings versus your feelings. Okay. So I'm going to begin with your I'm going to begin with your feelings, and then I'll go on to your person's feelings. And I'm doing it this way so you can know if this makes sense, because of course you know how you feel. So then you know if you've picked the right reading, because if this part doesn't make sense, then you can pick a different pile, but hopefully it does. Okay, so how are you currently feeling about your person? Okay, we've got progressions, journey. Ooh, square, semi-square, quincunx aspect, tension, and then Gemini cross-pollinates. Okay, so maybe there's been an argument recently. something about seeing some, like, both sides of someone. Because this Gemini is very, like, flip-floppy. There's the two sides, the two faces to Gemini. I don't know, maybe, yeah, there was something about your person that was revealed that you weren't aware of that caused this tension. But this could also be, like, sexual tension. You may be feeling like you really want to get close to this person. Like these two birds are, like they are drawn together. Even though it's a hard aspect in astrology, it's still a very powerful one. It can get things moving, but it can just be a bit tense or a bit restrictive at times. But there's something here about progress. So you may feel like you've made some recent progress with your person. You may have more clarity, more understanding about where you stand with them. This could be quite literal in the sense of maybe there's actual travel going on here. Okay, so you or your person could be on the move, and that's something that you're thinking about at this time. But this may also be that you are now, you're wanting the connection to move forward. So maybe it's been stuck for a while in one particular area. Okay, this was two that jumped out. I'm just going to get one more. Yeah, so maybe this is a sense of not receiving closure, or maybe you have received closure, the victory and success. Something about you understanding things more. So this could be even a self-discovery, something you've understood more about yourself through this connection. But it does feel, in this sense, you feel like the universe has brought you together for a reason. Now, whether it was to be together as a couple for the long term, or whether this is more about personal growth, that even through connecting with each other, feeling this tension, feeling the confusion at times, feeling a lack of control here with the Emperor reversed, Aries energy, that this may have made you conquer certain things within yourself. Certain aspects that, yeah, you felt like you didn't have control over. And of course, when it comes to relationships, we don't have control over the other person. And we should never try to gain control over the other person, because it always backfires. Maybe that's something that's already happened. But oftentimes the need for control stems from a place of pain, because it's trying to mitigate feeling pain. So maybe there's a part of you that feels like this person could severely hurt you if you let them, or if you opened up your heart to them. So yeah, I do feel like there's some protection here. And I do also feel that there is spiritual protection here. I feel like your soul has this purpose to help people, group three, which you may not even realize at this time. But the universe is protecting you from getting into something that's going to take you off your path of where you're meant to go, of your destiny. But yeah, there's something you feel happy about though, I feel, with this person. You feel that, yeah, you've achieved something. So maybe they reached out to you recently, or maybe they told a mutual friend that they were into you, or they liked something of yours on social media. There's something where it feels like a win for you. Now, if it's not that case, this may be, again, you feeling like you're over them, or you're starting to get over them. And that makes you feel like this is a success, like a personal success. Okay, so how are you feeling about them? We've got a new start is coming, new moon. Expect powerful change. Okay. Nothing will come of the situation. Okay, so I feel like you want the change. Okay, I feel like you want a new start. Okay, you want a new beginning with this person. Or you want to get over them. One way or the other, I feel like you are needing to progress now. You are needing to move forwards. So whether that is with them or without them, I feel like that's the place that you're in right now. You're not willing to go around in circles anymore. You know that nothing will come of the situation if it continues the way that it's been going. And obviously, as you know as well, you can't control what they do, but you control what you do. And I feel like you are definitely considering your moves here and whether, yeah, it's time to let them go or it's time to reach out maybe. Okay, especially if they were the last ones to reach out to you, maybe you're confused as to whether you should reconnect with them. But there's something about needing to make a decision here. But either way, it feels like a win for you in some way. It's definitely going to feel like, yeah, this personal win, this personal victory. Okay, so now let's get into your person's feelings, because I know this is the bit that you really want to know about. So I'm not going to spend as much time on your feelings, but hopefully that makes sense for you. Okay, so your person, the person on your mind, what are their current feelings for you? What are their current feelings for you? Okay, we've got debilitated, Pluto, and Mercury messages. Okay. So they do want to communicate with you. That's come through very clearly here. They do want to speak with you. Now, maybe they are, I feel like they're rereading some old messages that you sent to each other. And I feel like this person has actually written out messages to you, but not sent them. Okay, even if they have been reaching out to you consistently or more so recently, but I still feel like there are things that they've wanted to say and then they stopped themselves from saying it. There's this restriction here with the debilitation. So yeah, they feel like also the communication between you is restricted right now. There could even be an actual block. Maybe you blocked them. Okay, so they're now feeling like they can't reach out to you. Or they feel in another sense, this could be about their own need for control with Pluto, that they feel like they have to control themselves again in what they say to you or whether they reach out to you, or like they need to feel like they have the upper hand here. So I definitely feel like there's power struggles between the two of you. Both of you feeling the need to be in control, both of you feeling the need to be on top, to be the winner in some way. But it's hard going because you're both doing the same thing. And I feel like you both can be quite stubborn about that in terms of moving forwards together. And stubbornness isn't a bad trait, by the way. It can be a very good trait. It's fixed energy. It can help to achieve so many goals being in that way. And in relationships, it can be good. It can be show loyalty and sticking to things. But then also the shadow side of being stubborn is letting pride get in the way. You know, not doing things because, I don't know, for whatever the reason is, okay, that's causing them to hold back. But it doesn't feel like it's pure, or it's like, again, this needs to be right, rather than just thinking, I want to be with them. I want to rectify things. I want to be together. And that's the end. That should be the true end goal. But it's more about, okay, it's about the journey and the winning. Okay, I definitely need to get some more information here. So let's take a look. What else is coming through about your person's current feelings? Group number three. Your person's current feelings towards you. Your person's current feelings. Whoa. Disruption. I mean, look at that. I mean, that is Tower. The Tower. Material harvest. I just heard military. Someone could be in the military. Hope. Okay. So there's something about your person feeling a need to be single right now. Okay, they may feel like, yeah, they need to be single. They need to stand strong and be very independent. But then they also still have hope for the two of you to come together. Now, this may be that also they're doing very well financially. Maybe this is where their main focus lies. They're focused on their money more so, okay? But then the disruption, it's chaotic, it's unpredictable. I mean, look at him, how he feels restrained. Look, he's got handcuffs on or something that's restraining his wrists from moving. He's stuck in this position. And it feels like his feet are like tied to something, even though you can't see them there, but it feels like there's something that's kind of sinking him down. Like having a rope tied around his ankles and then a sandbag attached to it. Okay, so something that keeps them rooted to the ground and not moving, but they feel, it feels intense. I don't feel like they like that feeling because they want to feel free. They like to feel independent, but they don't when it comes to this connection. They may even be a bit obsessed. Yeah, and this may even be blocking them. The obsession is blocking them because like they're reading into things too much. They're not just going with the flow and taking a risk and allowing things to unfold. It's like they're over-strategizing everything, overthinking it all, and not, yeah, being spontaneous enough, not allowing themselves to be spontaneous with you. I mean, maybe that's because of what's transpired in your connection and they feel like they need to be very careful or they need to, yeah, tread lightly when it comes to this connection. So yeah, there's definitely fear there. Fear is driving them or is holding them back rather. But let's see what else is coming through about your person's current feelings. Adjustments are required. Okay. You are good enough, full moon in Virgo, and then confidence is your key to success. Leo energy here. Okay, so they know that there needs to be a change. There needs to be some adjustments here in your connection in order for you to either have peace, whether that's together or separately. So you're actually kind of mirroring each other in that way. Okay, group three, I feel like you both want some form of closure. Okay, maybe that you're very attracted to each other, you care about each other, but you may not feel compatible. Your lives may not be meshing well together right now. But I feel like your person wants a change. I don't feel like they've let you go because they're still holding on to hope, but it's their confidence that's getting in the way. Hence why they're overthinking everything. They write things out, they delete it because they don't have the confidence to actually go through with it and potentially be rejected by you. Okay, but that is their key to success and they know it. They know that that is the way either to win you over is by being confident, by being bold, taking a leap of faith. But they are afraid. Like I said, fear is definitely a driving force within them. You are good enough. This might be something that they want to tell you. If this is how you felt with this person, you may have felt like you're not good enough, or they may have treated you in a sense where you felt like you weren't good enough, but it's like they want you to know that you are. They do value you in more ways than I think you realize, but it's their own personal issues that are getting in the way here, okay? It's their need for confidence. They need to stand strong in their convictions, in what they believe and what they want when it comes to you. Oh, and it says fate. Yeah, so they feel like you were fated to come together in some way. They believe that. They believe that this was divinely guided. And yeah, you do too. You both feel that same way. But I also get this sense with your person that they feel like sometimes they need to leave things up to fate. Okay? They feel like they need to stop being so obsessive, stop overthinking things, and to go with the flow. So it's nice to see actually that they're starting to reach that conclusion, group three. But let's see what else is coming through in their feelings. Page of Pentacles. Okay, so they could be wanting to send you a message. I mean, that makes sense with the messages card there as well. Okay, so yeah, they're thinking about sending you a message. Four of Pentacles. The Tower again. And the Star. I'm just going to cover her up. Okay. So, hopefully you didn't hear. Can't hear my stomach rumbling. My apologies. Okay. So again, we've got the hope, okay? They do hold out hope for the two of you. You are like their shining star, okay? They are also incredibly passionate, highly attracted to you, okay? But there again, there's a lot of this tension. I feel like you both feel the same way. There's a lot of tension between you. So yeah, you may have had an explosive argument. Okay, well maybe this is like explosive activity in the bedroom, but it just feels like it's all over the place. It's very, very hot. And that phrase just came to me, if you can't stand the heat, get out the kitchen. And I've never used that phrase before. I've obviously heard it. So I feel like that was a channeled message, okay? If you can't stand the heat, get out of the kitchen. Now, there's something here that they feel like they need to let go of with the Four of Pentacles, that they've been holding on to things too tightly. And I really do feel like, again, it's their ego and it's that fear that they've been holding on to. And I feel like in order for them to reach out to you, they have to have that confidence. They know that they need to let go of their fears and they just need to go with it. They need to be spontaneous. They need to just flow or use the opportunity as and when it presents itself. Because it feels like in some way they sense like they've missed the boat. So maybe you gave them the green light or you gave them an opportunity to come to you or to rectify things, but they chose not to engage. Whereas now they realize they've got to do something. They have to make a move in some way. Okay, they've got to make some physical move, but they also know that they need to let go of fear before they come in. Okay, so let's get some fishbowl messages on this for you. Okay, so we've got no contact and avoid this energy. Winter, retrograde, karmic, IT consultant, and yeah, avoid this energy. Yeah, so I do feel like they're thinking about the fact that you're in no contact. It does feel like it's a no contact situation right now, but they don't want it to be. So the retrograde here is about them wanting to redo things with you, to reunite, to move things forwards again. But it's like they feel like they've got to go backwards in some way in order for them to move forwards. So maybe this is that they owe you an apology or some kind of transparency in terms of moving this forwards. But I mean, look, we've had so much karmic activity. We've had fate come through multiple times. So they either believed in fate before they met you or through meeting you and having this connection with you, they now believe in fated connections. And that it was meant to be, and that they're looking back on the way that you came together or the way that you first met and seeing how special that is. And they're feeling like that was not something that they had control over. But also I feel like how emotional or physical, all these feelings that they've been having for you, they weren't expecting. Okay, it feels like it just happened. Like they happened to like fall for you, but they didn't expect it or they weren't. It might not be what they were looking for or seeking, but it feels like it's something that just happened here. Now, maybe that's how you felt on your side also. Now we've got the winter card, which could be, maybe this is when you connected with each other was in the winter time or when you first met. Maybe they're going to wait until the winter before approaching. But clearly they want to reach out to you. They do want to break this no contact. IT consultant. So maybe this is something that they do for their work, or they maybe even consulting somebody that is an IT consultant, but about you. Okay. So I don't know what that's about. They could be trying to investigate something about you. But for a lot of you, this might even be just a friend. They've got a friend who happens to be an IT consultant. And they're trying to, and they're asking advice, getting advice from them. So let's just get some message cards now. Messages from your person, group three. Messages from your person. What's coming through? To lay next to you, bliss. Your dark side pains and excites me. So yeah, you definitely excite your person. And I feel like, yeah, they want to be intimate with you, but I feel like they just want to sleep next to you. Something about sleeping next to you, they feel like they would get the best night's sleep. Or if you have slept next to each other before, yeah, they feel like they sleep better in your presence. They feel safe, they feel at ease in some way. But then here, your dark side pains and excites me. So yeah, they see you having some sort of dark side to you, maybe something taboo, something mysterious or something hidden. But this could also be if you've inflicted some form of pain on them, okay? But it's like it excites them as well as hurts them at the same time. But it's also very bonding, because pain oftentimes is more bonding than love can be, which is unfortunate. But it's about the intensity of the emotions felt that will have an impact on the connection and the bonds that's created. It's not always whether it's good or bad. Usually it's a mix of both that becomes very addictive. And then the more I try to forget you, the more your name appears before me. So they can't forget you, group three. Even as much or as hard as they try to, they can't. So yeah, this is why I feel like they're very frustrated, because there's a part of them that feels like it's not going to work, but then another part of them that can't let you go because they're constantly reminded of you. They may literally be seeing your name and that's causing them to think about you, or maybe people they know have been talking about you, or they could have been receiving other signs that make them think of you, even like smelling like your perfume or your aftershave on someone else. Something about smell seems to be coming through. I feel like they really like the way you smell. Yeah. Something about whether it's your natural odor or again the perfume or aftershave you choose. It's like they're really drawn to that. But yeah, so they're definitely conflicted. But it does feel like they want to reach out. Whether they actually will reach out, I'm not too sure. And I'm not going to look into this now because my battery is about to die. So I've got to wrap this up. But if you like, I'll do a no contact reading. And I have done readings. If you scroll down, I've done one very recently actually as to whether they will reach out, whether they'll contact you. So you can always go to that if you want that kind of specificity. But today, this is what I'm looking at. Obviously, if I saw for sure that they were going to reach out, I would let you know. But I don't feel like I'm totally sure. I feel like they want to. I just don't know whether they're going to muster up the strength to actually do it. Okay, so of course, time will tell. But I really do hope that this makes sense for you. And if it does, please comment the glitter or star emoji. Okay, if you don't want to write something long-winded or something where you're being open, feel free. Okay, but it just lets me know that it makes sense for you, that I'm on the right path for connecting with your reading, or if you just enjoyed it. Okay, but you can also give the video a like if you enjoyed it, and subscribe if you want to see more of my channel and my videos upcoming. And if you'd like to book a personal reading with me, the link to my website is below. I do hope you have a lovely rest of your day. Bye for now.